Hello everyone, I'm Rachel from the Innisfil ideaLAB and Library, and in today's Tinkershop tutorial, we're going to learn how to design laser cut pins. Begin by opening the Inkscape program by clicking on the icon on your toolbar. When you first open the program, you'll notice that there is a square in front of your screen. This is known as your canvas. Anything that you design inside of this square will be captured by the program, and anything that you design outside of it will not be captured by the program. So let's get started. Now, the first step that I like to do is adjust my document properties. And I do that by going up to the File menu, clicking Document Properties. And I'm going to change units to IN for inches. And I'm also going to change display units to inches. In custom size, you'll see a width and a height. And when you type in the dimensions of the object that you want to create, you want to make it the same size. So if I want my object to be 2 inches wide, 2.00, and if I want my height, I'm going to put in also 2 inches. And you'll notice your canvas is now changed. It doesn't look it, but it's actually virtually 2 inches by 2 inches. Next, I'm going to import my image. When searching for your image, you're going to want to look for black and white images or vectors. We will be turning these into a vector, but it always imports a lot easier when you're looking for these hard line images. So for an example, I'm going to go to images. An image like this one would work very well. Same with this one, but these colored images would be a little bit difficult in order to trace them properly. Once you find your image, click on it, right click on top, and go to save image as. I'm just going to save it to the desktop for now. I'm going to close the Google Chrome program. And now I'm back in the Inkscape program. I'm going to import my image, and then I'm going to convert it into what's called a vector. So we go up to File, Import. I'm going to look for my image I just downloaded. I'm going to click OK. And you can see it's a little bit smaller here. So I'm going to click on my Move tool, and I'm going to click and drag my arrows just to make it a little bit bigger. Next, I'm going to trace bitmap it. So I'm going to go up to the Path menu, Trace bit, click Update, and then click OK. It doesn't look like anything's happened, but once you hover over top of your image and click and drag, you'll have two of them. You're probably thinking, which one is my good image and which one is my image I don't need? So to tell the difference between that, this one has a transparent background. You can still see the canvas behind it, while the other JPEG image, you cannot see it, it's blocked out. So we can click on this one and we can delete it. We will not need it anymore. The next step is I'm going to now make a copy of this, bring it over to the side, and what we're going to do next is create a cut line that's going to go all the way around our laser cut pin. You do that by separating this line from the rest of the vector file. I'm going to go up to the Path menu and click on Break Apart. You can see now that these are all broken up now. They're turning into different pieces. Now I'm going to click and hopefully get just the outside edge of our owl. I'm now going to turn it into a cut line. So right now our vector here is for engraving, and we're going to turn this one to be cut. We're going to go up to the fill and stroke icon. Right now it has a fill. We're going to click on stroke paint and add a stroke. And right now you can see that it's just a black outline. We're going to change it a different color just so we can see it. And I'm going to hover it right over top of my pin. Now you could have it cut directly on there, or there's another option where it kind of gives you a small border when you're cutting it. You can do that by going up to Path and clicking on Dynamic Offset. There'll be a small little triangle that appears on your line. Now if you click on it and drag it, you can see to kind of give it a border. Now the last step is I'm going to go to Stroke Style and turn that red line into my cut line. And the magic number for setting that in to be laser cut is under Stroke Style, Inches, and the number is 0.001. Anything else, it'll actually engrave. So if I click on the owl, you'll see right now it's zeroed out, there's no stroke, and there's only a fill. So that's letting me know it's going to be engraved. Well, the other line doesn't have a fill, has a stroke, and it's set to 0.001. So always remember that fill is to engrave and stroke is to cut. So finally, I'm going to save my pin now. I'm going to go up to File, save as, and I'm going to save it as an SVG. I'm also going to save it a second time. So I'm going to go to File, Save As, and this time I'm going to save it as a PDF, Portable Document Format. And I'm going to click OK.
Once your file's been cut out, take a pin backing and attach it with some hot glue.
And there you have it. I've just shown you how you can design a file that will turn into a laser cut pin using Inkscape. I'm Rachel from the Innisfil Idea Lab and Library, and thanks for joining me today. Take care.